That is delightful.
Yum.
Hello and welcome back to Curiosity Mine. A few years ago, we met up with Paul Sedowy to look over the items in an incredible collection of opalized fossils that he generously donated to the Australian Opal Centre's collection. You can watch that video here. If you haven't already, I very much recommend it. It was the first video on this channel to reach 100,000 views. So thank you to everyone who's contributed to that huge number. I recently met up with Paul again, this time to have a look at another collection of unique and colourful objects that he's donated to the Australian Opal Centre. But this time it's not opalized fossils. It's a collection of opal specimens and oddities, unusual pieces, and even a mystery or two.
I always looked at these things and enjoyed them, you know, and that was part of the joy, but now everything is going, and it's like this whole process has been a letting go process. You know, it's interesting, you have stuff for 20 years or something, and then you let it go. And so the whole life, I've done 35 years of collecting, and a lot of specimens miners don't actually give a lot of credit to, because you know you can actually cut it out and sell the stone quicker, but when it's in a blow or it's in its actual host rock, it becomes more of an interesting collectible item. And most of them I never sold. If I found them, I just kept them, put them aside. So what you see here is going to be parts I've collected from 30 years, but I've just collected it. Now, this is an amazing opal mosaic. This was done by an opal cutter here called Julius Dietius. I think in his mid-80s he made this.
Julius Dietius was a Polish immigrant who came to Australia in 1948 and came to Lightning Ridge in 1969. He is one of the most respected opal cutters in Lightning Ridge history, and his mosaics are the stuff of legend.
And I was actually there lucky enough to see him make it, because when I was mining here, he actually taught me how to cut opal. So that was in the 1890s, I was cutting for him. Then I walked into his shop in 2000, I saw him actually making this piece. So I had to have it, because it's just good memories. And it's in Len Cram's book on Lightning Ridge Opal called Lost Sea Opal. But the workmanship is just unbelievable. It's a fantastic piece. And it's the same as I also got him to make up a business card. Now, this is, I used to always show somebody the card. This is from the Opal Association. So he made a replica with same Lightning Ridge crystal. And it's always been, had a lot of impact, and I've just enjoyed it, so. And this one has an incredibly detailed analysis of how the opal has formed. So it's only just a specimen, but you can see how all the opals form down in layers and swirls. It's like magic has formed underground, and that's what's made some of the colour on top. So I've got an incredible detailed analysis of how this actually formed, or someone's theory, but it's something like that. It's just interesting just to see and try and understand all the turmoil that came into creating this opal. So the colours is not fantastic, but it's still got a bit of mauve colour, a bit of black. But the beauty is in the formation, how it's laid, then how you've had all the swirling effect, then forming the opal. Like, I just think it's an incredible specimen. Just not nice to look at. Yeah, so this is one of my favourite specimens. This is gem crystal opal, beautiful green fire. I got a pocket of this 20 years ago, but I kept this one piece. The rest I cut. You can see a little bit of dark grey here. I got a couple of really nice stones out of this, but decided just I like the look of this, so I just left it. Whenever I put this on, say, Facebook, I just get tens of thousands of views. It's one of those that just people, is that how you find it? Look at the colour. It's like a lolly. You can nearly eat it. The colour's so vibrant, and knowing that it cuts some good stones, there's still some good stones in there, but as a specimen, I just think it's not worth its weight in gold, but it's special. It's pretty neat, yeah, lovely colour.
I just think they're neat.
This is a massive, large knobby. It's nearly 500 grams. So it gives an example of when you're mining opal, look at the size of the knobby. But what stones you're going to cut out of it? A 1 carat stone, little cheap stones, that's all that's going to come out of it. But the formation of the specimen, due to the size, and it just goes, it's not easy to get the opal, and it's only going to cut small stones, little fluffy stone, and tiny little pointers. So a huge big stone can have a very low yield, but as a specimen, it's pretty amazing. Just give an example of just how hard it is to find the opal sometimes. It's a nice specimen. Now this is a huge slab that came from Cooper Petey. You can just make out the colour here. It's probably a little bit deeper in it. This has been resin coated, which is something I wouldn't do these days. I'd leave a natural and polish it. But it gives you an idea. You see how it's formed. Then it's got the natural fractures. So these, you only cut different stones out of it. And if you look at the fractures, you've got an iron stain in there, which means that it's been there for a long time. So you cut a couple of different stones out of it. But as a specimen, I'd be inclined to maybe take the resin off and repolish it, and it'll make it look a bit different. But it's, so just a little specimen from Cooper Petey, a couple of 1,800 grams of opal. So, yeah, so it's something pretty neat. Now, this is an interesting specimen. This is actually like a tease of nature. Your rarest colour combinations is red on black. So this is just a bit of seam opal, and it's very thin. It's just on the front of the sandstone, and it's like shin cracking material. And this is, couldn't cut a stone out of it, but you're getting the colour play there. So it just gives an example of how nature teases us and makes something unique like this. And you get some idea of just how rare the colours are. Like, actually there, I can see a little bit of the red flash move across. So as a colour combination, to find a teasing like this, it's actually rare, because red may be only, red on black is 1% of what you find. So it makes it such a rare item. But to see it on here so thin, it's actually just a bit, look how thin it is. It's actually just a real tease. That's all it is. Well, this is another interesting specimen. This is, this part here was actually used in a magazine, the ICA, the International Coloured Stone Association, put out. And it was talking about the formation of these little parts through here. Now, this all came off the one piece. So I thought it's interesting because there's a detailed analysis of this piece here. And this is the piece that it came to. But unfortunately, there's one little piece missing we can never find. But just to explain how opal forms, that's interesting in itself. So if you're interested, just look the article up.
Curiosity Mine is on Patreon. Patreon is a service that allows you to directly support your favourite creators to allow them to continue making the content that you enjoy. If you like these videos and you think Curiosity Mine deserves your support, head on over to patreon.com/curiositymine for more information on how you can support the channel directly. If you do, you'll get your name on this list of amazing people who are supporting the channel already. So head to patreon.com/curiositymine. Or curiositymine.com/Patreon. Both of those will get you there. But for now, let's get back to Paul's collection.
Now this is a pretty interesting little piece of opalized timber and vegetation. You can see some of the wood in the grains. And this has come from Springshaw in Queensland. So, you know, when you drive up to the Winton Show, you pass through Springshaw. And it is opalised, there's no player colour, no fire, but it polishes up well and it's just a great little specimen. Well, this is the last find that came out of my mind at Lummo's Retreat. So it's just been a little knobby there, and open it up, look at that. So I made a joke that if this is a pearl inside, but it's like a secondary deposit. So it's got this little dome there. I've just hit it slightly to polish it, but look at the colour and fire. So you see there's no colour on the outside, and you're opening up, look at that. Yeah, just a bit of a novelty. It's unusual, and it's just the centre of the opal. So it's all being formed in layers.
This piece is an excellent example of a kernel, where a secondary deposit has formed within a different piece of opal, or is it the other way around? For more about kernels, check out this video from a few years ago.
Now this is what we call a bit of a nature's mystery. This looks like a bit of a pumice, but it's, you know, it's volcanic, which we don't really get here at the ridge. But it's got a beautiful little green fire that comes across the whole stone. So it's just such an unusual little piece. So you can see a little green fire from it. It doesn't float. So stay tuned, we'll try and find out what it is.
I don't know what that specimen is, apart from absolutely fascinating. So this piece is from Lightning Ridge, and just to be clear, while this looks like a volcanic formation, opal and geology in general at Lightning Ridge is sedimentary, not volcanic. So yeah, it's a bit of a mystery.
Now we've got here is a nice bit of seam from the sheepyards. It just gives you where you actually find the opal. So here we have an interesting stone. It's a flat, very thin, but you can see where it's come from. It's actually come from this little piece on the side. So that little bit of green you see there is going to cut probably a 5.5-carat stone in there. Now this piece was actually near the end here, and there's other little bits and pieces. So there'll be long, thin little stone here. There's a little bit of green you can't see, but the main piece is here. You can see the green goes all the way around. So you're going to get a nice green stone there, and it's going to be a sister to that one. So it's an interesting specimen. It just shows you when you see it in the wall, it looks thin, you don't think there's much there, but you can still cut some lovely stones out of it. Now this is an interesting little specimen. I actually just nicknamed it opal stalactites. It's from the roof out of sheepyards, and it's like the opal has seeped down and then filled up all those little fracture line fissures here. And it's made a real jaggedy effect. And so it's unusual formations from the roof. And, you know, I just think I call it a stalactite for want of a better name. That's about nearly 1,000 grams just of as a specimen. Well, this is a nice highlight specimen. Came from the New England Plateau in New South Wales. So you don't get a fiery colour, but it's all clear. You'd actually, bigger pieces, you can actually facet, make a little faceted stone. But it does like fire. You have some highlight from Mexico that's more orange colour, but most of the Australian is a little bit creamy to crystal clear. But still, it fluorescence too and looks pretty neat. Now this is one little specimen that we find just in one field called Andamooka. It's virtually up the sandstone, the opal seeps in, and they just call it a painted lady. Now I remember one miner telling me it's like a lady, beautiful on the outside and hard inside. That's where it came from. But some stunning colours. Right, so this is what we got here. This is just a specimen of pink opal from Western Australia. When you open it up, you see there's a dendritic inclusion in there. Now it's a mineral inclusion, but it looks like a fern leaf, unusual. Now the prospector called this pink opal, and it's actually a mookite, but the Western Australian Mines Department actually called it pink opal. High in silica, polish is fantastic, but this is just unusual to see the dendritic specimen inside. Yeah, so this is an interesting little ironstone boulder. So you just hit the top, and there's inside a little cavity. We've got a little bit of gypsum forming in there. So you can see all the heat and pressure that's formed it. I went up to the Winton Show one year, went to a mine, and this was laying on the side with the top off. They thought it was nothing. Oh, what a great little specimen. So can I have that? And sure, there you go, look at that. So it's like just a little cavity in there. You can see all the heat and pressure and the little formation of crystals from there. I just thought, it's no colour, but what a great specimen from the opal fields.
Gypsum or calcium sulphate often forms adjacent to opal. And while they are nowhere near as geometrically satisfying as the gypsum cubes inside that boulder, you can check out this video for some examples of how gypsum appears alongside opal in Lightning Ridge opal mines.
Now this is a what we call fairy opal from Queensland. It comes from Mayan Upper Junda. It's actually a treated stone. So it's a natural stone, but when you find it, it's like sandstone with flecks of colour. So basically, by just putting it in sugar or oil and heating it, it brings a black out. Now, unfortunately, you can't get a good polish on it, so this has a resin finish on top. But look at the display of colour of the red and fire from it. It's still impressive. It's still a magic and mystery of nature. Just stunning. So this is our best fairy opal that we've had. Like for the fire and the glow from it, it's a different market. But to get a piece like this, it's still a collector's item. It still has so much beauty in it. Now, fairy opal. So look, here we got here. It's a huge, big lump of rock. It's only an unusual example. It's like a large angel stone here, which is high in silica, very tough, and you got opal formed inside of it. So you'll see around the little bits of colour jutting out on a few little other parts of the specimen. But the main part is just it's unusual to find it formed in here. It's not gem quality, but just how it's actually formed in nature, it's pretty interesting. Now this is probably one of my best specimens of a material that comes from Yawa. So it's sort of known for Yawa nuts. But look, when you open it up, look inside there. Look at that. So the name of this material is meant to be opal conglomerate, but I think it's a bit of a terrible name. So we call that opal fusion. It's like all these little nuts in there. Look at the two big stones there. So this piece, a beautiful specimen, to cut in the middle, and you can just see there's just nuts everywhere. Look at that. Just go nuts looking at something like that. Just amazing. That is my best specimen from Yarra in conglomerate. There's bigger specimens, but I think the quality of this one's pretty neat and spectacular. Yeah, what we got here, these are actually some more fairy opals from Queensland. Now you've got a neon electric green fire here, then you have the one of the rarest colours is your red colours. So both these are just unique stones in their own right. You can just see they're both being treated. There's only a little colour bar on the top there. You could cut a lot of stones out of this, earrings, sets. But it's a treated stone, just been resin coated. But the size and the fire and the beauty is still there to see. And this one, you can see it from 60 yards away. If you hold it out in the green flash, what the hell is that? So it's just something, unusual specimens of size and colour. So it's fairy opal from Junda in Queensland. And now this is a nice specimen. This is called Antamooka Rainbow Matrix. So it's actually a treated stone, but still has some amazing patterns. It's not like hard matrix, you can't get a polish on it. So this has to be resin coated. So it's a treated stone. You can see how we've left, just rubbed on the side. The treatment only goes in a few mil, but it's a permanent treatment, and it's just a beautiful showy stone. Great pattern.
So that was an incredible collection of opal specimens donated to the Australian Opal Centre by the infectiously enthusiastic Paul Sedowy. Opal specimens are wonderful things. These weird and quirky formations can tell us so much about how opal forms, both broadly and at a more local scale. Opal miners are inherently curious people, and most miners collect weird things that they find underground. This collection represents 30 years of Paul's fascination with opal and the geology and mystery that surrounds it. This video was made with the help of the Australian Opal Centre at Lightning Ridge, with special thanks to Paul Sedowy and Jenny Brummel. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to Curiosity Mine on YouTube and maybe even supporting the channel directly via Patreon, the link's in the description. And thank you for watching.